Hi everyone, let's welcome to SOAP UI testing tool. Our agenda in here is to learn the web services testing using SOAP UI, both manual and automation part of it. So basically what we are going to concentrate in here in this video series. So let's get in to see the topics. So what we are going to cover as a part of this video series, you can see it from here. Basically, first we'll go into the introduction of web services. Like we'll be learning the terminologies, what are the tools used, what are the different, what is the difference between SOAP UI and REST. And then we'll get into the prerequisites like installation part, and then understanding the Pistol, what Pistol is. So what basically is important for us for SOAP web services testing is Pistol. So that's the prerequisite to kickstart our testing with SOAP web services. So we'll try to understand that in detail. And then we'll start installation of SOAP UI tool and navigation of our beta screens. And then before that, I wanted to explain how we segregated these topics into. First, we'll have the prerequisites, basic introduction and all those things, and followed by the manual testing part of the SOAP UI tool. And then we'll be getting into automation part using the Groovy. And then we'll be seeing the various topics which we'll be covering under manual and automation part. The same part which we covered under manual, we'll see how to automate using the Groovy scripts. So in manual part, what we are going to cover is like the basic introduction, like how to import a Pistol file, how to create a project, sample project, and how to create test suite, test steps, test case. And then we'll send out a basic request to the server with the hard-coded values and see the response, and then followed by assertions, what are the assertions basically available as a default when we are creating the test case and also test step. And also we'll see what are the other assertions that are possible. And then followed by, we'll be removing the hard-coded values and we'll be using the properties files to get the values from the variables and utilize it in the test steps. And then we'll see the property storage at various levels, like the project level, test suite level, test case level, and also at the global level. So this we are going to cover it. And then we'll be seeing this all things on a sample calculator application, where it was freely exposed on the web. The visual file for the calculator application is exposed, and we'll utilize those visual file for the calculator application. And then we'll start utilizing that thing, and we'll follow the same thing, like creating the sample project for calculator application, and then we'll be working out with various requests for the calculator application. And then we'll be putting out some assertions. The default assertions we'll be looking into, and what these assertions tell us, and how to use these assertions. And also we'll utilize some of the other assertions like valid HTTP status code, XML match assertion, etc. And then we'll come to see how to utilize the dynamic, how to handle the dynamic values. That we'll be using through property transfer using GUI, and also we'll be doing it using the Groovy script and the automation part of it. So here we'll be taking the property of property from one test step and then reusing another test step. So it is like in general terms we'll say that request chaining, and then we'll be creating a mock service. Basic idea of the mock service, stub and all those things, we will be going in detail. And then we'll create a mock service and run the mock service, and then we'll be creating the mock operation for the mock service and run the mock service. And then we'll put some tests under the mock service and verify the response received from the stub is correct or valid or not. And then coming to the automation part, the Groovy, using Groovy, the same thing what we have done in the manual part, will be modifying it to support it through Groovy. So what basically we are trying to achieve using, what automation part we are going to do it. So why we need automation part? So basically, if you are having multiple test steps, assume like 10 test steps you are having, if you wanted to run the 10 test steps, you need to manually do it one after the other, one after the other, one after the other. But while coming to automation part, through Groovy script, what we can do is like we can put all the 10 steps and call the 10 steps from the single script. So that's where automation part comes into a very good handy way. there are some other advantages of this Groovy script. We'll be looking into the thing at the time of property transfer and all those things. So basically what we are going to cover in the Groovy script, the basic steps, what you have done in the manual part, the same thing we'll be doing. And then we'll be seeing what are the objects available in the Groovy script. Then there are three basic objects that we'll be covering up: context, test runner, and log object, and uses of each. And then we'll try to work out the calculator example with the Groovy script. And then how to handle the dynamic values using the property transfer. We'll be seeing in the manual part with using GUI, but in here with the Groovy script. And then that's it. This is the part of what we are going to cover it. And then one more thing I forgot to mention. That's okay. So we'll also be having a topic covered. That is like a data input from the Excel sheet, CSV or an Excel sheet, and then we will be iterating over that one. So multiple values from the Excel sheet, we'll calling out multiple values from the Excel sheet, and we'll be running the script. So the data-driven testing will also be done. It was not covered in the index, we need to put it out. So this is all what we are going to cover as of now, and some more things will be included in the next sessions. So in the next sessions, what might be coming? So we need to still have something like seeing the results. When we run multiple test scripts, we need to have the results, individual results in some Excel format or something. So that will be taken up a bit later. This is all what we are going to cover in here. And thanks for watching. If you are still interested in my other videos, these are the links to my other series of videos on Selenium Automation Framework Design from Scratch and REST API Testing Postman Series. Where REST API Testing Postman Series is almost completed, and Selenium Automation Framework Design from Scratch Series is in progress. And you can get all the scripts available in this blog. Whatever I will be teaching, all the scripts will be available in this blog. You can just check the blog and get the scripts from there. Thanks for watching. Let's get into the introduction. Thank you.